My name is Ross Pogson, and I am the Collection Manager for Mineralogy and Petrology at the Australian Museum. A mineral is a naturally occurring chemical substance with a fixed atomic structure and a fixed chemical composition, or one that varies only slightly. One way of classifying minerals is by their chemical groups, like oxides, carbonates, and by crystal shape. So mostly a combination of chemistry and crystal structure. New minerals are being discovered all the time. There's about 6,062 separate mineral species, and more are being added every year. Minerals are very important to our everyday life. We use them in cooking, they're important for health. We use them in construction industry, electrical wiring. There are so many purposes for which we use minerals. I think the most interesting example of how minerals are used in technology is to look at our display on a mobile phone and just see how many dozens of chemical elements go into making various parts of that mobile phone, including critical and rare earth elements that are in short supply and very hard to get. When you hold a famous and rare mineral in your hand, it's a great privilege. And you think about where it came from and the long transport that it took to get to, you know, where I'm holding it in my hand.
I'm Dayna McGeeney, Technical Officer, Geologist and Gemologist in Mineralogy and Petrology at the Australian Museum Research Institute. In the Mineralogy and Petrology collection, we have about 81,000 registered specimens. It's the oldest rock and mineral collection in Australia, and the mineral collection alone is the largest in Australia. The oldest traceable specimens in the collection came from a mineral dealer in 1862. Another way of answering the question of oldest specimen in the collection would be to look at the geological age formation. In that case, it would be the Jack Hills conglomerate specimens from Western Australia. The zircons in those rocks have been age dated to 4.4 billion years old. There are a few challenges involved in maintaining these collections. Temperature, humidity, dust, even light can affect some specimens if they're susceptible to fading or darkening. Other challenges are they're rocks or minerals on rocks, and they're heavy, sometimes incredibly heavy. So you need to be cautious for your own well-being, as well as the space, the floor that you're storing large collections on. The research value of the mineralogy and petrology collection is immeasurable. Planet Earth is a rock. The study of geology is based on rocks and minerals, and that underpins all of the natural science research, as well as human beings living on this planet. Agriculture, building foundations, metals, ores, energy, everything.
I'm actually the museum's longest serving employee, having worked here for 44 years. I became interested in rocks and minerals from a very early age when I was taken by my parents to Farul Beach, and I started collecting the round stones, which we called lucky stones. There are many challenges in arranging mineral exhibitions. Our collection is of such a high quality and has such depth that it was very difficult for me to choose one superb specimen from another group of very superb specimens. And I would encourage anyone to come into the museum to see this collection, because it is a sight you will never forget.